you're turning me into that weird girl that doesn't have stuff because of your stupid internet business. You know, please can I have it? And so my first response is, then do me, you know, make a persuasive PowerPoint. So what that means is, so I have kids who come into my office and they beg and pester and harass their parents mercilessly to get this game they want or this social media app. And the parents are always like, I'm going to get to that, I'm going to get to it, I have to research it first, I'm going to get to it. And after a while, they never get to it. So they're like, fine, I'll just let you have it. And I'm always like, why are you doing all the work? They're the ones who want it. If they want it, make them do the research. And then, you know, you can fill in the gaps. So that's what I do with my kids. If they really want something, first of all, they have to do it, but really want it bad enough to even hassle with a persuasive PowerPoint. But they have to come up, they have to research it themselves. So they have to tell me what it is, what it does, what safety measures are on there, what kind of monitoring, what kind of risks and benefits there are, right? What the age, so they have to present that to me, and then I still have every opportunity to say yes or no. That's how my daughter got her goats. She did a persuasive PowerPoint. She separated her mom and dad because she knew that we'd influence each other, and she pitched us hard for those goats, and we both said no. We both said no, and then 2 months later, she had her goats because it worked on us. So I told her to do a persuasive PowerPoint for Snapchat. I haven't decided yet what I'm going to do because I preach no Snapchat. But she's starting to wear me down. But until she gives me that persuasive PowerPoint, she has to talk her dad into it too. So far, I'm safe. And my son, he's too lazy to do persuasive PowerPoint. So when I say do a persuasive PowerPoint, he's like, forget it. It's not worth it. I'm like, cool, then you don't get it. Gradually roll out one thing at a time. Don't let them do all at once. And I talked about the probationary periods. And when you do download the app together, review the safety features, if it's moderated or if it allows blocking, and make sure you set those privacy settings. And that's, you know, pretty easy. Be careful if it's anonymous. They can pick screen names that aren't their real names. Discuss who's allowed on their buddy list, right? Make sure you're on it. So every social media app they have, you want to know their username and their password so you can get into their app at any time. Otherwise, you're not going to know what's going on. And make sure their older sister's on there too, so she can text you and say, hey, you need to check that out, right? And never post when on their social media. Even if it's the cutest, most amazing picture you ever saw, don't like it, don't comment on it, because it's their private spot, and they'll hate it. And that'll damage that parent-child connection. So you're allowed to be on it, but just don't post it, because that will make the object of ridicule for their friends. Don't hold your child responsible. Go home tonight and set up a Google Alert. Does anybody know what a Google Alert is? So a Google Alert's really easy. Just go into your browser and say, what's a Google Alert? It'll teach you how to do it. You set up a Google Alert with their name, and then anytime their name appears on the internet, you'll get an email about it. So one of my kids has a name that's the name of a famous author, and so whenever she's touring or writes a new book or has a movie out, it tells me about it. But it's worth it. So when if you set up a Google Alert, if you just Google their names, you'll find out if they have a Google footprint already. One of mine does because she was on a club sports team and they put her on their website, so there went her footprint, she's already rolling. And you know, when you're signing school, this is a private school, so I don't know what kind of procedure you guys have, but in public schools, you're required to sign a consent form for any images that get taken because most schools have their own social media channels and they like using pictures of the kids learning in their environment so parents can see it. I choose not to sign that because I have this high-risk business now, right? So I don't want my kids used for marketing purposes, so I won't sign it. So in that classroom, now they have the list of parents who don't sign that aren't allowed, and those kids, then any photos that get taken cannot be posted on the school's website because I haven't allowed it. I'm not saying that everybody else shouldn't allow it either. Every family should make their own decision because footprint, you know, I do post their pictures like crazy on my Facebook page, but my private Facebook page, not my Get Kids Internet Safe Facebook page, because I don't want their images there, just their profiles. But it turns out facial recognition now adapts profile pictures, especially Facebook's. Theirs is better than the FBI's. So that Google Alert will alert you anytime. My Google alerted me, and there was a comment I made in 2009 on an Apple Mac forum about photo storage that came up. So you just never even know, you know, what you do online that's going to follow you around for the rest of your life. Thank goodness that was kind of a lame comment I made. But I certainly, when I was going into the forum trying to find out how to download all my pictures on my computer, I had no recognition that that comment was going to follow me from now on if anybody interested in me. All right, once they have social media, be prepared to see the stressing stuff. You're going to see a lot of it, right? I now see everything that her friends Instagram and all the stupid words they use and how homophobic and sexist and violent teenagers actually are. That's a bummer. Set a good example. Look out for redirects on social media. So when they have a social media app like Yik Yak, or say even on Instagram, they'll say things like, kick me at, you know, basketballhoop.com or whatever. And that means that they're alerting their friends that this one's monitored by their parents, but they have a side social media app that their parents don't know about, like Kick, and that's where all the action. So they're really genius at communicating through these very sneaky little things about how to get to other apps. And now you can also sign up for other apps through Facebook, so you don't even need to sign it up through your cell phone. So you'd have to be willing to check their phone often to find all their little genius workarounds. Digital citizenship. So I'm big on love and protect. I'm constantly selling this to my kids, and I tell it to my clients all the time, that, you know, your job in life really is to protect yourself and protect others that you love. So I'm often saying, you know, when we're talking about their siblings and how they're drawn with each other, you know, but what did you do to love and protect? That those relationships are really important. They're going to be your best friends forever, or they're not. But it's up to you to make sure they are. So that you need to treat people online just as you do offline. Especially, you know, somebody like me who's 48 years old, I live in my hometown where I went to elementary school. You know, and not only do I know everybody that I went to elementary school, middle school, and high school with, but I've treated everybody in town, or I've taught them at the university, or I met them at Kent State Hospital, or whatever. So whatever I did in fourth grade now still follows me to this day. And so I tell my kids, like, whatever you do now, I follow you forever. Like that one kid that asked you for a nude, that kid, he might be your boss someday and or up to hire you at something. So be careful the way you manage things. You don't want to be too brutal, but you also need to protect yourself and be assertive. So that kind of online reputation is critical. Don't overshare. There are now businesses like Josh Oaks, who I need to contact, and he has a business that teaches parents how to set up, how to stylize their child's social media apps. So when it's college time, that child looks like they're the best, most creative, rule-abiding citizen ever born on the planet. Because colleges will ask for usernames and passwords of all the social media apps to check out what the kid's been up to. And they'll consider that when they're picking their applicants. So will future employers. One of my clients didn't get hired because he didn't have a LinkedIn. So it's not a reasonable solution to just not have a social media app. Sometimes having a social media app is what gets you the job. But it has to be stylized so you don't have your solo cups with your tequila with your best friend when you're a junior, right? So middle school assembly, you know, are you cool with everything on your social media being shared with grandma and everybody else? In regard to that relationship, teach them how to trust their gut. You know, that's a lot of what I do in therapy. You know, teach them how to make good decisions and read their emotions and consider those little messages, that inner voice you hear. It's important. And when you overlook it, you may be in trouble. The earlier you start listening to yourself and that emotional triggers you get, the better prepared you are to protect yourself and the people that you love. And in regard to privacy, so Jackie Irwin's our local assemblywoman, and she launched the 2016 legislative season with a child identity theft bill. So she sponsored a presentation for me last year, and her office called me and said, you know, hey, Dr. Bennett, do you know anybody who was the victim of identity theft? And I was like, no, but I'll Facebook it. So I Facebooked it, and within an hour, I had three victims and interviewed them and then gave them to her for press. One was a 40-year-old guy who, at 10 years old, somebody got a call with a warrant for his arrest. And since then, he has endured enormous hardship from that identity theft. He's been unable to untangle from it in 30 years. He's been called into child support court, because he was falsely accused of being the father of children and owed child support, one that he would have had to father at 10 years old twice. He's had to do DNA tests to prove that his paternity, he can't own property under his name or social security number because the creditors come after him for all these false allegations that he can't get out from under. And he's the sweetest, coolest, most awesome guy. In fact, he said he was heading from Oxnard to Camarillo to become a priest, and he got pulled over by the police, a police officer who said he had a warrant for his arrest, and he said, look, I'm going over to become a priest. It's because I'm a victim of identity theft. And the guy said, okay, if you're lying to me, then you're going to come to my lieutenant and apologize in person. And he said, fine, and if I'm not lying to you, you're going to come to my deacon and apologize to him. The police officer had to go to church and apologize. So he's a super sweet guy. And as a result of that identity theft story, Jackie Irwin got it passed, so yay for her. She's the head of the California Cybersecurity Committee, and she passed that, and what that does is it requires credit card companies to put blocks on kids' information. So children's social security numbers are now the number one target for identity theft. So what happens is they get a hold of your child's security number, and you don't recognize that there's been fraud on that account until they're old enough to take out their own loan at 18. And by then, there might have been, you know, 2, 5, 10 years worth of fraudulent activity to the tens of hundreds of thousands of dollars. That's what one of my other cases had. So as a result of that, I wrote an article about how to block your kids' social security number. You just call Experian. You have to give them very specific information, send them a letter. They'll put a freeze on your kid's social security, so if anybody tries to use it for a loan of any kind, they can't. And if you want to know how to do that, just go to the blog page, put cybersecurity in the search window, you'll get the article that tells you exactly how to do it, and it's worth it. I did it for my youngest too. My other one, she's 22, she's out already. Make sure you check photos for geotagging, because that says exactly where that picture was taken, and they can locate your home that way or your child's school. I told you to choose anonymous usernames already. And, you know, let your kids know that if they're sending new photos, that they, whether they send it, accept it, or get downloaded at all on their device, that they may be eligible, or not eligible, but liable for a child pornography charge. Now, we've had some kids show up on sexual predator lists because they downloaded a picture of a peer, even though it was mutually consensual. I think that's a crime that would happen to that child, you know, because everybody's doing it and that one kid got held up as an example. Law enforcement is less and less willing to do that, thank goodness, because that child predator list, that's going to follow that kid around from then on because he was 14, you know, and accepted a semi-nude picture of his girlfriend. That to me seems unreasonable. But it does happen, and every state's different and every community's different. That Jamie Bartlett thing that I have, so I put his hour-long video up for free on my website because I think it's awesome. And that same day we had a Beverly Hills police officer who specialized in cybersecurity do a presentation as well. So I haven't put that up yet. But he talked a lot about how local police officers are also monitoring regularly. And our juvenile division officer, I run into him all the time, we present together. So the police officers, they're getting more and more sophisticated in investigating and interrupting those kinds of processes. So you don't have to write these down because you're getting the slides. If you give me your email address,